In a previous video, we discussed key points relating to conducting research with human subjects, with the underlying theme being to do no harm, or to protect the research participants. But the concept of doing no harm also relates to other aspects of the research process. So that's what this second video will focus on, a few more key points, primarily dealing with reporting research. The first key point relates to language. Use language that is appropriate and understandable for your audience, both the research participants and those who will read your research. The language you use in a consent form for a child, for example, will likely be much simpler than that you would use for adults. Think about it. If I don't understand the language, how can I truly give informed consent? The same holds true for the language used to explain the study and the language used while conducting the study, such as in a survey instrument, as well as for debriefing after the study. Language choice also relates to the audience for the report. If you are writing a report for an academic journal, you will use scholarly language. If you are preparing a press release, PR Newswire suggests a concise one-page write-up, very direct and factual, and avoiding industry jargon. This relates to honesty. Not only do you need to be honest with participants, and we've discussed that earlier, you need to be honest when you report the study results. Full reporting means that you include all relevant details, including any errors or omissions that may have occurred during the research. This is not only ethical, but could be helpful to other researchers who might want to replicate your research. Be careful of overgeneralizing, openly acknowledging alternative explanations for the results that you are reporting, and of course, not plagiarizing. One thing full reporting does not mean is that you have to provide every single detail. Remember that some information, such as who said what, is confidential. And consider that if you are conducting research for a private company, the research is likely proprietary, and you can't ethically release the results or talk about them to others. And it is not only ethical, but appropriate to give credit where credit is due. Much of the time you have developed your research after reviewing the research of others, so you should give credit to those who inspired you in a literature review. If you are replicating another's research, you should note that in your report. And you also rarely conduct a research project completely on your own, so you should give credit to the research team. And if you are conducting the research for an organization, you likely got some sort of assistance from that organization, so you should credit them as well. And occasionally, you may give credit to the research participants. Again, if you think about it, all of this circles back to the concept of doing no harm, not only to the study participants, but to those who read your research and those who have helped you with it. The bottom line, however, is that the burden of being ethical throughout the entire process falls upon the researcher, you. Processing time. What role does honesty play in the research process? And how does the concept of do no harm affect the research reporting process? Just a few more thoughts for you to keep in mind as you ponder the importance of ethics in research.